We are on our way down to Dorset to adopt some expat chickens. They have come out of the farm this morning, and so we are just on our way to Stoke Wake to adopt four lovely chickens. So I'm really excited because I've not had any for about, oh, must be 9 years now. So yeah, so we're not far away, so we will see you soon. Really excited to take them home because they've never seen the sky or the trees or the grass, so it's really exciting for them as well. They've got a lovely house and run to come, and we've actually got six instead of four because they had lots of extra chickens, so I took two extras. So yes, and they all seem to be in fairly good shape. There's not that many feathers missing. They've just had their claws clipped as well. They do that before they send them out, so all very exciting. Now I've just got the drive home, and then we can release them into their new home, so we will see you a bit later. Thank you.
No, they're very good. I've seen a lot worse.
Yeah, I've had worse ones than that. But I mean, they soon grow, the feathers. That looks like the biggest one. She's quite big. They sort themselves out, don't they, so that there's like a hierarchy, one in charge. So that's it. Journey done. And I've got chickens again, which is brilliant. Morning, ladies. We're going to come out. Come on, then. Come down. I'm not going to come out now. Gonna let them try and figure it out for themselves how to come down. Come on then. Come on. Once one comes out, the others will just follow. Come on then. There you go. Come on, ladies. Okay. This is one of the omelette igloo cubes, the large one, and one of their walk-in runs, which is 6 by 9 foot and 6 foot 8 high. I started off with the little igloo cubes years ago, and I've always just found them safe and they're easy to clean, and they last longer too, and there's no maintenance as in having to keep up wood or anything like that. So yeah, and this came with the feeder and the drinker, and you can buy the covers as well, but we're going to make our own. That's two chickens out. Come on, ladies. Come on, then. This is probably going to take a while, so just leave them for a bit. I will come and get them out if they don't manage it on their own. Come on! That's it. Come on. Come and get some breakfast. Come on then. Yeah. That's it. Down you come. That ladder's got special plastic bits on so you don't cut your feet. Come on then. Come on. Say good morning. Did you have a good night? A bit more peaceful today. It was a bit of a long day yesterday, wasn't it? Lots of excitement. Yes, you can scratch and eat and drink all day long today. This is what's so lovely. They've just never seen any of this. Just being outside and being a natural chicken. So that's what I love about rescuing them. Because you're giving them something that they should just do naturally. That one is very, very hungry. She's not stopped eating. Fill that up a bit later. I'm going to shut this. Is that what you're wary of? Were you just looking out? Shut this. Yeah. Right.
I'll see you a bit later. I think we can safely say that they now feel at home. She's been the last one to go in at night. All the others go into the house and she sits on the top and waits till 10 o'clock when I come out. Good morning. It's going to be really hot this weekend, so the ladies have been here a week tomorrow, so I've made sure that I've cleaned them out. They've got two lots of fresh food. There's a dish under the house, fresh water. I've swept all around the run and I've stood up all the bricks just to stop all the bark chippings from coming out. It doesn't matter, but it just causes a bit of a mess, so I just thought it'd be better that way. It stops it coming out. And I had two old cat litter trays, so I've put in some dirt out of the beds, made sure there's large stones and any bits that shouldn't be in there have gone. And as you can see, one of the chickens at the back is having a lovely dust bath. They enjoy that, it gets into all their feathers and any mites and things that are irritating them. And then these two are just pecking in this one. I will give them red mite powder, well not give them, I will put it on them in a couple of days. I just wanted them to settle down first. And in their crumb mix today, I've just put some of the layers pellets just to start changing them over from the crumb mix to the pellets, and they've been eating that. So I've got six very happy chickens this morning. They've settled in very well, so I'm really, really pleased. We had the little Union Jack flag. I've just popped that on there. As they are came from the British Hen Welfare Trust. If you are interested in adopting any of these lovely ladies, I will leave the link below. They are coming out of the farms all the time throughout the year. You just have to go onto their website and click onto the map, and it will show you chickens all over the map. And when that chicken turns red, then that's when that particular place will be releasing them. Otherwise you can just ring them, they're quite happy to talk to you and tell you what happens.